Hi, my name's Nick Peachy, and I'd like to tell you a bit about my digital classrooms project. Digital classrooms will be a series of books, digital e-books, aimed at English language teachers and helping them to use technology in new and innovative ways and to combine technology with traditional classroom practices. The first book will be on using digital video, both inside and outside the classroom, and looking out at how teachers can exploit this medium to create engaging and innovative and interesting materials for their students, I guess. As this is a digital book, there'll be an iPad version and a version for other e-readers or to use on the computer. I'm hoping that it'll be video rich and have lots of embedded video tutorials in it, and also some interactive images. The iPad version will probably be a bit more interactive than a PDF or EPUB version, as iBook Author allows, which is what I'm going to use to create it, allows for a bit more interactivity and a bit better end product than some of the other authoring programs. The book will include some information about different learning theories that support the use of video and blended learning and flipped learning and things like that. And we'll also look at tips for how teachers can create video lessons for their classroom and some of the do's and don'ts there. There'll also be tutorial videos to help teachers use different online tools that you can use in combination with video to create interaction or quizzes or things like that, or video editing and things like that. So there'll be a whole section on the kind of useful tools and how you can use them with video tutorials to support that. I wanted to start with a book on video because I think this is particularly suited for a sort of the ebook format. It'll allow me to embed videos in and reference videos and things like that. And I think doing a book like this in a paper-based format would be very dry and would leave out a lot of the very innovative things that we can do on a digital book. Well, firstly, I don't think a publisher would want to do a book the way that I want to do it, with videos embedded and things like that. Most publishers, when they produce a teacher development book, want it to have a 10-year shelf life, and I don't think that's practical for a sort of modern book on technology. I also want to challenge the established way of doing things. You know, I think ELT publishers and commercial interests have dictated the way we use books within ELT and the way teachers developed for far too long. You know, I think you know, we're coming to a stage with the technology where an individual teacher can actually use the technology to produce a book that's as good as something that a publisher would do, and is really directed at teachers from their own base knowledge. I also want to produce the book much more cheaply than a publisher would do it. Teacher development books now, if you look around, cost about £20 each, which I think is ridiculously expensive. Even ebook versions cost about £20. You know, the republished versions of something that was written years ago. You know, I don't think ebooks should be that expensive or need to be that expensive. And I think I can produce something better for less. So, you know, I'm hoping to be able to produce this book for about £4 or £5 a copy, which will mean more teachers can afford it, they can carry it around with them on their digital device and access it whenever they need it. And you know, for me that makes much more sense than working with a publisher who's going to charge £20 for a book. Yeah, well, yes, most of my other work has been produced for free and published for free online, which is part of the reason why I'm trying to raise money for this project, really, because I haven't made anything much from the stuff that I publish freely online. The other reason is that I want to sort of put more time into developing this and develop something that's much better quality than the stuff I've published online for free, you know, and that takes time to really produce something that's professional and has good quality video in it, good quality images, taking the time to go into more depth with the writing. You know, I think I can produce something better if I have time to do that. But having that time means taking time off for the things that I do every day to pay the rent. And so, you know, I'm asking for the money to sort of back the project and help me to develop it, something that's better. Yeah, the money that I raise from doing this book will also go towards the next book and hopefully creating a series of books. I've got lots of other things that I'd like to write about, you know, things like mobile learning, developing digital reading skills online. There's plenty more to come in the series, so if I can get this first book and raise enough money from this first book, then I can keep doing the rest of the series without having to come back and without having to use advertising in the book or anything like that. So it can be a much better product. Well, I guess the first thing you can do really is back the project, back this project, whether it's with a donation or whether it's with one of the rewards. That would be great. The other thing that you can do is share the project, share a link to the project with friends or anyone else who you think might be interested in backing it, and just share it around, and hopefully I can raise the money to produce this first book and go on to produce a whole series. Okay, well, thanks a lot for your time and for listening to what I have to say, and I hope you'll read through the rest of the information on the project, and that, you know, together we can make this book happen. Thanks a lot.